Hi everyone and welcome to another Java tutorial. In the previous episode we were writing this awesome program Hello World and we were debugging it to see if we could find any bugs, and in this episode we will learn about, wait for it, bits. And what is a bit? A bit is a binary value. It could be 0 or 1. If you take many bits in a row, then what do you have? Well, then you have a byte. And oftentimes when you write that you have many of something, you could write that, oh, do you know, I actually have this many bytes, then you just use the capital B. But if you write lowercase b, you're saying I have this many bits, so it's quite important to look at the suffix or whatever it's called after a number. Is it a byte? Is it a bit? Is it a kilobit? Is it a kilobyte? Okay, and what I will teach you today is how you take this seemingly ununderstandable binary number and convert it into a decimal number that you can actually understand. So one thing we could do is to just make a simple exercise to understand how we convert a value into its decimal representation. So if we have 140 here, maybe 142, I think that would be more interesting. And we think about how do we interpret 142. So what most people do is that they think that one here, it symbolizes 100, which could also be written as 1 times 10 to the power of 2. And the same goes for 40 here, that 40 could actually be broken down into 4 times 10 to the power of 1. And 2 here will be 2 times what? Well, it would be 10 to the power of 0. So you can see that we see a nice pattern here. We have 0 and then 1 and 2. So for 2 here, we can just write 0 on top here. And then for 1, meaning for 4, we can write 1 here. And for 100, we can write 2 above it. So this order here, or position, tells each number how valuable it is. So what we do for each of these values is that we just multiply it by 10 times its position in this whole number here. And if we add everything together at the end, just as a sanity check, we should see that everything equates to 142, just as we expected. But what happens if you were to have another number, let's say 1010? What is this even? So if you think about what we have here, is that we have a value in a 10 based system. So in any position here, you have 10 different options. You can have 0, you can have 1 through 9. So that's 10 different characters that we can choose from. It just happens to be that we have chosen to use these symbols that looks like 1, 4 and 2. But you could use letters A, B, C, D and just count with them in the same way. But this is just how we have been brought up and how we think about numbers. And if we look at the process we had here, we could actually formalize this as an equation. Because we are taking the sum here of all of these different x can symbolize these different numbers at different positions I. So I here would be like each of these positions that you could have, where I could be a value from 0 all the way up to a value of 2 here. And what we do for all of these values is that you see that we take the value xi, multiply it by the base that we want to convert this value to. So the base would be 10 here, but let's just be for base. And then we raise it to the power of the position we see the number in. So that will also be I here. And you don't need to care so much about this, but this is essentially what we're doing here with this number. So if we apply this process to this binary value here, what do you think will happen? Well, if we take and we just write out the position here, so 0, 1, 2, and 3, just as we did here about the decimal value, and then we take this 1 here, or, I mean, here we did everything from the opposite order. We started with 2, then 1 and 0, but we can start from 0 here. So we take 0 times the base 2 to the power of the position, which is 0, and then we take 1 times 2 to the power of 1, which is the position here. Then we take this 0 here and we multiply it by 2, the base, to the power of 2. And at the end we take 1 times 2 to the power of the position 3. And then if we add all of these together, we will get, so what will we get here? Here we will get 0, here we will get 2, here we will get 4, and here, no, we will get 0. Haha, try to trick you there. And here we get 8. So if we add 2 and 8, we get 10. So this is actually how you convert from a binary value into a decimal value. And something you may notice is that if you look at the pattern here, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, you can see that in the 0 position here, if you would have a 1, then you would get 2 to the power of 0, which is 1. And if you go to the second place and you have a 1 here, that would represent 2 to the power of 1, which is 2. And in the next position, 2 to the power of 2 is 4. And then here, 1 times 2 to the power of 3 is 8. And if we were to continue here, maybe you can guess the next value. So it would be 2 to the power of 4, which is 16. So what we're doing between all of these steps here is that we are just multiplying by 2 to get to the next value. So the next value you can see from 16 would be 32. And like the memory sizes that you have had in your old MP3 players or in your maybe your SD cards, it also follows this this pattern here. So the next one would be 64. And then we could just write 5 here, and then we could write 6 here. And you see that in every place where we would write a 1 here, we would actually add the corresponding number here to the total value. So if you were to give me a really hard number that I were supposed to convert into a decimal number, I could just use this table here and convert it. So let's say someone gives me the value, let's just separate everything here so we know that we're only dealing with this. Someone gives me 47. If I wanted to write this as a binary number, I can just look in this table and see here, what would happen if I take 64 and then add some other numbers to it? Well, 64 is clearly above 47, so we cannot write a 1 here. We'd had to write a 0. And since this, the first number here will be a 0, we don't need to care about it. Just as if you were to write 047, it would still be 47. Let's just remove that. So the next here, the next value, 32, that is actually needed to create 47, because it's lower than 47, so we write 1 here. So if we take then 47 minus 32, you will see here that left here from 7 minus 2 is 5, and it's a bad 5, but it's good enough. And 4 minus 3 is 1. So we need to add additionally 15. And 16 happens to be a bit higher than 15. So we need to write a 0 here. But if we were to write a 1 here and also add 8 to 32, we would get 40. So just to continue, if we have 15 minus 8, we see that we get, what is that? That's 7. Just divide 7 here. And since 4 is less than 7, we can write 1 here. So if we take 7 minus 4, we will end up with 3. So we can add 2 here. We subtract 2, so we have 1. And then we add a 1 here, minus 1, and we have 0. So now we have actually converted 47 in the decimal system into its binary representation, 1 0 1 1 1 1 in the base 2. So if we then were to plug this into Eclipse, let's just switch from the pen tool to this, and then what we can do to check values is actually to write it here. We just write, let's get rid of those quotes, we write 1 0 1 1 1 1, and then we try to print this out. And if we just hit play, it will just print it out as the decimal value. But that's not what we want to do. We want to operate in the binary domain. So to do that, we write 0 and then b, saying that this is these are bits that we are trying to print out. And now if we hit run, you will see that we get the value 47. I always switch it up. We get the value 47, just as expected. So this is how you basically do that conversion. And I think that's all you need to know. Thank you so much for watching, and see you in the next tutorial.